name is Jerry McIntyre. I'm the owner and MD of Cootehill Precision Engineering in Cootehill, County Cavan. At the start of 1992, when I started up, I started off with a couple of machines. One of my first big breakthroughs was to get a job at Abbott, you know, a multinational company. And I was so delighted to get it, and I manufactured it, gave it down to them. And they were very happy with it, and I was even more delighted when I got the cheque of £67 for it. They lodged in the bank straight away. Cootehill Precision Engineering is famous for friendliness, to be able to talk to people at their level. When somebody's trying to explain to you that they want a job done, but they're not just 100% sure, that you can grasp all that information from them. They know what they want, but they don't know exactly how they want it. So it's figuring all that out and being able to deliver them a quality product at the end of the day. Over the years, the Local Enterprise Office has been very helpful with financial assistance and grant assistance to buy machines, with mentoring and with training packages. And they're constantly running them and they're constantly updating them, and they've been of real value to people like me. Over the next few years, Cootehill Precision plans to expand even more, with maybe going into 3D printing for printing consumable parts and special purpose one-off parts for customers to see what the part would be like before we even go down the road of designing it even further. We will invest in more equipment and more staff as well. There's always challenges, no matter where we go. Because we live on the border here, we have, you know, currency fluctuating, but we have to live with that. I'm not going to move the business, so we have to deal with it. There's highs and there's lows, but we're going to move forward. There's no doubt about that. Some of the best advice I got when I was starting up in business was just to be honest with people, to be honest with your customers, don't tell them a lie, or don't tell them you're going to have something made for them when it's not going to be done. If I promise a guy on a factory floor that he's going to have a part on a Monday morning at 9 o'clock to change it, and he hasn't got it and production stops, he's in trouble, I'm in trouble, that's probably me gone for him. If for any reason I thought I wasn't going to have it there, I would tell him 4 days before that, look, I've had a problem, I'm sorry, really sorry, I can't make it. He is better off knowing, at least he can reschedule. Be honest, keep talking to them, and they'll always be your friend and they'll always be loyal. When you're trying to attract a new customer, you really got to find out all there is to know about that customer and that company before you make any approaches to them. That when you do start talking to them, that they realize you understand their business. And if they feel that you understand their business enough, you have a better chance of doing business with them. Regarding costs and all that, I mean, you have to keep on top of your energy costs. The one that, you know, if I had let my energy costs go on this year, they would be up 20%. 20% is enormous. You know, after a lot of dealing and haggling, it's gone up 2.5%, which to me is too dear. It shouldn't be gone up. The team of guys that I have worked with me are there for, I'm 24 years in business. We work with each other. We always help each other. We're part of a family. I always get the return from them, because my business doesn't just open the door at 9 o'clock and close at 5. It can be Saturday, it can be Sunday, it can be 5 o'clock in the morning. So when I need them to walk, they step up to the mark each time. And I'm very proud of them. It's a great business, and I love it, and I love coming to work every morning.